Hello, welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial, I will explain to you how you can make a camera follows a path, just like you are seeing now on the screen. This is a simple tutorial, so let's start it. Let me just create a new file over here. And now, I will remove the light because we are not going to need it. Select it and press the delete or the X key. For this tutorial, I am going to use the default cube and the default camera. That's no problem at all, because this is only to show you how you can make a camera follow the path. That's not important, the object that he's filming, okay? Let me just activate the screencast keys over here so that you can see on the bottom left of the screen which keys or which mouse buttons am I typing. It's easier for you. And the next thing that we need to do is to select the camera and press the N key. Go to the item menu and adjust the rotation to 90 degrees. If I press 1 to go to the front view, the camera now is parallel to the floor. That is just for this tutorial. You will need to make these settings according to your needs. So now that we have done that, we need to create the path that we want the camera to follow. You can create a custom path, okay, by click on Shift A and go to the curve menu over here and select Bezier, or you can create a circle. In this case, I am going to create a circle so that the camera follows around the cube. So Shift A and select circle. Let's just scale it a little bit because he was created inside of the cube. Again, you can create a custom path according to your taste or to your own needs, but for this case, just to show how it works, we are going to use the circle. After the circle is created, click on Tab to enter in edit mode and select one vertex. Okay? Now that you have selected that vertex, press Shift S and select the option Cursor to Selected. I have made this because I want the cursor to be here, because I want that the camera will go here too. So the next thing that you need to do is to select the camera, press Shift S again, and selection to cursor. Now that we have our camera here, we need to make some adjustments on the rotation again because the camera is pointing to that direction and I don't want to do that. I want the camera to point to the cube. So here on the Z-axis, I think that you can put 90. No, not 90, maybe 0. Okay, that's 0. Let me just open over here a new window so that you can see what the camera is pointing to. Press the 0 key, and as you can see, the camera is pointing to the cube. Okay. Now let's just adjust some settings. This is up to you. You can select the objects and press S to scale it. Okay. Now we have move the objects far away from the cube, as you can see here, or you can move it closer. You can move it up by pressing G, okay? But I will leave it just like this. And now select the camera, select the curve, and press Ctrl P, okay? Now you are going to make the camera linked to the curve. And now the option that you need to select here is follow path. Okay, let me just remove this menu over here so that you can see better. After doing that, after clicking on follow path, if you press space to activate your timeline, as you can see, now the camera is moving around the circle and your object is going to appear here. Okay? That's a pretty easy thing to do, but most of the people doesn't know how they should gonna do it. So I hope that you like my tutorial, and I hope that it was helpful to you.